I was actually crying when I finished the script. So that was my first reaction, but just I read the whole thing in one sitting, in one go. I didn't move for kind of like 2 hours. I just read the whole thing page to page and just loved it. I was kind of like, wow, where did this come from? And I called my agent and just said how much I loved it. And then I went back to Brown, and I ended up speaking to a bunch of my friends, and I mentioned the name of the script that I'd read, and it turned out that, three or four of my friends were actually huge fans of the book, and they started talking to me about it, and it turned out that, this book has this amazing following, and yeah, it was great. There's no way that you can read the book having been through, any kind of, high school experience or, and just not, or even not even a high school experience, but just having been through being a teenager and not be able to relate to one of the experiences of the characters. It's just so, it just covers so much, and it's so real. It's so true. And I didn't need to go to an American high school or go to prom or like or any or have any of those kind of experiences to be able to relate to Sam or Charlie or Brad or any of the characters. When I came onto the movie, I was very anxious about, doing loads of research and trying to figure out how I was gonna create these kind of like friendships that they've obviously had for such a long time. And I was really worried about it all and was, I doing all this prep work, and Stephen was just like, you don't even have to worry about that. You're all gonna be best friends. And I was like, really? He's like, yeah, you're all gonna be best friends and you're gonna have the summer of your life. And I was like, okay. And it turned out to be totally, completely true. Like, I've met probably some of my, friends for life on this movie. Charlie is a he's a kid who's been through a pretty rough time, and he is the sweetest, most sensitive soul you will ever meet. And when we at the time we meet him at the beginning of the movie, his best friend Michael has just died, and he's in a really scared, anxious place. He's like just he's just coming to a new high school. He's just meeting new people. He's dealing with this loss. He's dealing with his like awkwardness and then and Sam, I think even more than Patrick at the beginning, she really sees that, and she's kind of like she decides with Patrick to take him under their wing and to take care of him and kind of like shepherd him through high school essentially, which can be, an intimidating place, and we kind of, yeah, we make it okay. Watching Logan be Charlie is just devastating. Ezra and I have watched the monitor a bunch of times and just looked at each other and been like, he so innately understands Charlie's awkwardness and kind of his innocence. And Logan has that. It's interesting. Logan is incredibly smart and, very professional and very hardworking. But then there's also the side of Logan that's incredibly just like sweet and very, he just thinks the best of people all the time. And that's Charlie. And he's just, and he also has that kind of like honesty, that purity. Patrick is the most charismatic, person you'll ever meet. And that's really who Ezra is in real life. He's this incredibly witty outcast basically at school who is so over high school, who hates it. And he's very unconventional. He goes against the grain. And he's Sam's best friend. All of the characters have quite serious storylines and are dealing with some quite difficult, serious stuff, But it's also very funny. It's always juxtaposed with something very funny and humorous. So, and that's, I think, when things are the saddest and the funniest is when you have that contrast. It's been absolutely amazing to have the man who, conceptualized it, who dreamed up my character, who dreamed up the whole world, directing it as well as writing it, as well as, having already released the book. It's such a pure line of connection, and he has such vision.